This looks quite satisfying. What a treat. Mm-hmm.
The Gerudo lived in a settlement in the Gerudo Desert. Comprised entirely of women, they were a tribe of great might and nobility. For her exceptional strength and her ability to harness lightning, Urbosa, chief of the Gerudo, was the clear choice to pilot divine beast Vah Naboris. Zelda knew Urbosa, thanks to her close relationship with the late Queen of Hyrule. With her party in tow, Zelda traveled to Gerudo Town to speak with her old friend. However, their journey took an unexpected turn.
Go! Why? What are you doing?
Thwarting your destiny, of course. Princess Zelda. I came back as quickly as I could. Not exactly what I expected to find.
Abosa?
I hope you're not hurt, little bird.
I'm not.
You've got some nerve, thinking you can go toe-to-toe with Master Koga! I'll show you! Yiga, assemble! Me excluded, of course.
What?
Next.
not on your side.
Ha ha ha!
How could these losers defeat me?
Master Koga.
Suga, you're late! I nearly got peeled like a banana! Oh!
Forget these cowards. It's time to retreat.
I think not.
Thank you for meeting me here. The town is a bit, chaotic, shall we say.
Of course, Abosa. We'd meet you anywhere.
You know about the Yiga clan, I trust. Sheikah traitors working in the shadows to revive Calamity Ganon. Those lowlifes have been wreaking havoc here in Gerudo Canyon. How long can we stand by and watch them get away with it? No longer, I say. I will pilot this divine beast. You are precious to me, and you need my help. I cannot refuse.
Thank you, Abosa. As Princess of Hyrule, I too will carry out my sworn duty.
Little bird. However I am able to support you, I will. Just say the word.
So, you turned and fled. Is that it?
Well, if they hadn't interrupted me...
It seems that, as low as my expectations of you were, I was overly optimistic.
What?
Well, no matter. My harbinger. Show me the future.
Oh!
Yes. The future, as it will and must be, I will not allow anyone to alter its course.
It will be my honor.
Thank you.
This looks quite satisfying.
The long-lived Zora, who could traverse rivers and lakes with ease, lived in Laneru, at a resplendent place dubbed Zora's Domain. Mipha, a Zora princess with the power to heal others' wounds, was selected to pilot divine beast Varuta. Accompanied by Link and the rest of her party, Zelda headed to Zora's Domain, where she was granted an audience with King Dorophan.
Faith she will do her utmost. With your permission, of course.
This will be a dangerous mission. Piloting the divine beast against the darkness. And I understand that the knight who will seal that darkness has not yet appeared.
That is true.
I must refuse. I cannot send my daughter into such peril.
But I...
Your Majesty! I bring news!
Well, Link, you've grown since I last saw you. And yet, you have not changed. This creature is a guardian? How cute.
Princess Mipha! Monsters on Ploymus Mountain, marching this way.
What of my father?
His Majesty is leading the army to intercept. He thought the prince was here with you.
Sidon is missing. We will find Sidon. You must watch over the domain.
Highness.
Thank you.
Lady Mipha.
Thank you.
would you try to fight that beast alone? I was so worried about you. But still, I am proud. What a brave little brother I have.
Thank you. This attack proves your point. We are woefully unprepared to defend against the Calamity. The Zora will face this peril head-on. We must consider the future. We all share this land of Hyrule. So all of us must do our part. Mipha, attend.
Yes, Father.
You will become the pilot of the divine beast, Varota. On one condition. You must promise